Guys, season 2 of Locke and Key, for the lovers of Harry Potter movies, the Locke siblings is a breath of fresh air. I won't do any spoilers. But to discuss a love triangle, who would want to be in a love triangle? Nobody. But being in a love triangle with a demon. Happy Halloween. This video I'm posting on Halloween.
Love triangle.
Really the kind of stuff Insane. That Halloween is made of. A love triangle with a demon. Imagine that. We all know what happened. If you watch season 1, Tyler had actually taken this prone, unconscious demon who you all thought was dead because of the face to throw behind the Omega door. And then we find out Gabe had used the iron key to being Dodge. And we know that Dodge is Gabe. Here we are, the beginning of season 2. If anybody had doubts, there is Gabe in front of the Omega door.
What exactly does it look like?
It looks like lead.
It's very rare in this world, so start searching.
Lead?
Yeah.
Like gray rocks.
Mm-hmm.
Gray rocks. Gray rocks. If only I could find some gray rocks.
You ever think that if the bullet that shot out of that door went another inch to the left and didn't hit Eden, you'd be nothing more than a glob of metal on the ground?
Yeah, well, it didn't miss.
Whatever it is that they threw behind the Omega door, it wasn't Gabe. So what exactly is going on in Madison that there is a love triangle with a demon? Well, choice and just luck. The choice here is Kinsey herself when in season 1 she uses the head key, gets into her head, and evicts fear, thought form that took human form. Literally hit it over the head with a spade and buries it. Because horror movie, isn't it? Horror series. Done it, she painted her hair purple, you all remember. And stood in front of Scot and Gabe and said, I like the both of you. I did both of you. If you so take it or leave it, Scot left it, Gabe took it. And here's why the lovely Kinsey Locke finds herself up triangle with a demon. She chose the wrong guy. That's what I would say. And Gabe the demon, arch enemy of the Locke siblings, doesn't come with good character references. He had a night of passion, sexual passion, nothing less.
With a brother.
Tyler, you might say this demon took advantage of him. Masquerades as the very beautiful. And that role is acted by the very beautiful Brazilian model. Then we know he gave his Dodge. Dodge is the demon. And now he's been the one dating Kinsey. And Gabe has a reason for being close to the Locks. He is their arch enemy and he wants the key. Kinsey should have been with Scot, most people would say. Scot welcomed them into Madison. When she was cowering, feeling lonely and left out in school, eating her lunches on the stairs, who was there for her, Scot? Who welcomed her into the first, you know, in high school, people move in little groups and cliques? Savini Group, the Nerds, making a short film. Who invited her to it? Scot, her best friend. You could see the sparks between them. Because she threw out fear from her head. She's the girlfriend, kissing and cuddling with none other than the demon. I guess when they're not talking about the keys, but then his own investment in this whole thing is the keys. He wants the keys at all costs. So they are enemies, but here he's masquerading as her love interest, doing everything. Is he doing it just for show? Being jealous, being possessive, and all those kind of things, what a teenager might do. In fact, he's been taking a trip into her head. That's another thing, you know, sharing everything. So basically, this love triangle, we can see Scot loves Kinsey. But every time Scot gets close to Kinsey, there's Gabe pulling away the hand. Guys, season 2 is back with a bang. I like it because so many loose ends. We found out at the end of season 1 that Gabe is a demon. So that fact is out there. But Kinsey does not know. The Locks do not know he's a demon. Everybody else from the audience. That's the good thing with being the side of the film. So in season 2, we know that Gabe is still around. So he was not the person who looked like Dodge, who was thrown behind Omega Door. He's alive and well. Okay? He's looking for rocks, whispering rocks. So he intends to make a key with those whispering rocks because keys whisper. Also, he's now in cahoots with none other than Eden, who he clearly identifies as a demon by come out scuttling out of that abyss or portal, or whatever it is, looks like a world of chaos. I believe him when he says, in our world, in our realm, chaos consumes us and we consume chaos where there are no rules. As random can get. We eat, we consume chaos and chaos consumes us. He's so chaotic. He's very chaotic in Kinsey's life. But he's acting the student in love here. So this love triangle is the Halloween is made of Inception. Such an exceptional film. They are layer upon layer. And you could easily think that Joe Hill, who writes this, has taken this very much at heart. He obviously must admire the Nolan brothers because he put layer upon layer. He put a demon, made him also act the monster. Actually, a demon masquerading as a, well, as the teenager, he really act a monster. How deep is that? That's layer, three layers, like the layers of dreams. He's not only a monster, he's undercover as a monster. He changes faces, and then he goes on to act a monster in a film, in a horror film, when he's actually the horror himself. Anyway, never mind. Scot has told Kinsey already. So when they gather again, the group, Kinsey encourages Scot to tell everybody. And so Scot comes out with this. I may be going to England. I've submitted the spluttering. They're very impressed in this college, Rochester. And he might be going. And who is the first person to go to him and say, it's a very good idea? Gabe, of course he would be happy because competition for the girl would be gone. I really don't know his gig here, the demon. Does he love Kinsey or not? Well, as the teenager, he really shows signs of being jealous of his girlfriend and protective of his girlfriend. He won't let Eden even suggest that they should kill her. Whenever Scot is around, he puts his hand into Kinsey's, Gabe takes Kinsey's hand, kisses her, walks away with her, all those kind of things. So always, always, always does that. Always restore her trust or dispel the suspicion that he can see is growing. He decides to set a trap for Scot. And for this, he needs the services or the help of his, of the demon, the newly arrived demon. I call her. She's told to go and steal the music box.
I'm still here, and I'm still the director.
Dude, if you get into Rochester, which I'm sure you will, you don't want to leave us hanging, do you?
Yeah. It might actually be a good idea to discuss other scenarios. Just in case.
Right, so I'm being caught on my own film then, am I?
No, Scot, you're just trying to keep one foot in the movie while the other one's already in England. You're being a little selfish.
Scot, what the hell? Oh. Hey.
What are you doing?
I don't know.
Scot! Scot! Scot!
Whoa, yo, chill out.
Scot, walk at Gabe aggressively.
Can we just... Relax.
Scot, punch Gabe.
I'm not doing anything.
Scot!
And now you see, this is Gabe. He's carrying on like a normal young teenager. He's jealous. He's up to no good. He manages to paint Scot in a very bad light with Kinsey. And actually, Kinsey ends up taking the heart Gabe, who has just been hit so much by Scot. So Scot is in the bad books. And on top of that, Scot is supposed to be leaving for England. So imagine. So Gabe is now closer to... So obviously it's now close again to Kinsey, who has to go and nurse his wounds. I would say everything, if you set aside the fact that he's a demon, you'd say just like any other young teenager is jealous. He wants to be the only one in Kinsey's heart. And so far he's succeeding. How this will hurt Kinsey when she notices that not only is Gabe a demon who has been, through her, getting very close and inside, in fact, not only close to her family, but inside her family home. She has been risking the life of her family. But not only if Tyler confides in her, what about that night of passion that Gabe and Tyler had? This is a demon who really is not worth her time. Love the mystery. I love the magic.
Season 2.
And it continues. Locke and Key.
We expect to see